Mkono, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Asanteni kwa kuweza kuwezeshwa na Mwenyezi Mungu kuweza kufika mahali hapa kwa ajili ya ibada hii ya katikati ya wiki. Tarajia mmeweza kuwa na siku njema, na kwa wale walikuwa kazini pia mmeweza kutekeleza wajibu wenu ambao mmeweza kutengewa na Mwenyezi Mungu kuweza kutenda. So kwa wakati huu nataka tukaweze kuingia katika kipindi cha kuweza kusifu, kisha baadaye tukaweze kusikiza neno. Haya, makofi kwa Bwana Yesu.
Oh, wonderful day. And I'm so happy to see you this evening. To our online viewers, my name is Reverend George. Jehovah has done me well by saving me and having mercy upon my life. And he has sustained me by his grace. So I'm grateful to Jesus for giving me an opportunity to be here tonight and even to start here so that we can speak the word of God. To those who came with the Lord, bless you and do you good. Let us pray. Our God and our Father in heaven, we are so grateful, Lord, that we found it is worthy for you, Lord of mercy, to bring us together in your sanctuary. The Bible says, Lord, you're so faithful when you bring your people together. You don't bring them, Lord, in vain, but there must be something that makes you, Lord, to bring them together. We pray tonight, Jehovah, that which made you, Lord of mercy, to gather us in your sanctuary, Lord, despite the hassles we've had the whole day. Lord, you're going to accomplish a certain purpose in our lives tonight in the name of the Lord. I pray that, Father, you speak and communicate to one, to the person who is listening, Lord of mercy, to this voice this evening, O God, that they must have you feel it is worthy that they came tonight to the glory and the honor of your name. Spirit of God, we request you, we pray that we continue ministering alongside me, that Lord, everyone that I'm going to communicate it to bring Jehovah impartation to the lives and to the ears of your children who are listening tonight in the name of Jesus. We praise you, God, and we honor you because this we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen. Let's celebrate our live viewers as we take our seat. Yes, 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 our online church. God bless you for coming, for also tuning in from the comfort of your house or wherever you're watching us from. God bless you. And we are always blessing the Lord together with you. And your feedback are very important every time that you view or you watch us online, whatever the feedback you give. We always appreciate God for that. And I always say that in case of any prayer item, just the number below the screen there, you can text, you can call, that you'll be assisted in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I bless the Lord that it is the midweek of the week. It is at the middle of the week. And Jesus is continuing to empower us every day. And I thank God that this week we have decided to dedicate it in prayer. And I know there is a God who listens to prayers. Hallelujah. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to listen. And prayer is communication with God. Prayer is communing with the heavens. That on your behalf, this is what I want the heaven to do for me. So not unless we make sure that we spend some quality time before God, then we are not assured of us being answered. But every minute that we pray, we really need to be before God, we really need to connect with the heavens so that now we can ask for help that comes from heaven. Amen. So it is important for us as the children of God to communicate with the Father. And us and him, he is going to meet with us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Our time is not so good. And I want us to read from the book of Jeremiah 3 and verse 3. The Bible says, call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things which you do not know anything about. Call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things which you do not know anything about. 1 Kings 18, verse 36, the Bible says, at that the usual time of offering, at the usual time for offering, the evening sacrifice, Elijah and the prophet walked up to the sacrifice. At the usual time for offering the evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet walked up to the altar and prayed, O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, prove today that you are God in Israel and that I am your servant. Prove that I have done all that at your command. Lord, answer me so that these people will know that you, O Lord, are God and that you have brought them back to yourself. Verse 38, immediately the fire of the Lord flashed down the heaven and burned up the young bull, the wood, the stones and the dust. It even licked up all the water in the trench. And when all the people saw it, they fell face down on the ground and cried out, "The Lord, He is God." Yes, the Lord is God. Praise the Lord. Tonight, the wonders we handle as a topic on the God who answers, or the answering God. Praise the Lord. The answering God. I have begun by saying that if there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. And if there is a God to answer, then there must be a person to pray. For you to be answered, you must ask for something. And that's why we read in Matthew 7, 7, the Bible says, "Ask, it shall be given to you. Knock, the door shall be opened. And seek, you will find." Meaning, not unless I ask, I am not going to receive any answer. Not unless I knock, that door will still remain closed. Not unless I seek, I am not going to find anything. Praise the Lord. So as a children, as a child of God, for you to receive any answer, any solution to anything that you might be looking for, it is you need to take your time. You need to take your chance, and you take a position, and by answering or asking and seeking and knocking, so that now you may receive. And Isaiah says, "I was so ready to hear their prayer, but there was no one who prayed." Meaning our God is ever faithful, very ready to answer the prayer that I, His son, is praying. You, as His daughter, you pray. But what happens is, there is no one who is praying. Now here the question comes, how come that God is saying, no one is praying, and we should pray? Meaning, I pray or we pray not in accordance with the will of God. Hallelujah. The reason why we pray, Father, in Jesus' name, we ask this on behalf of who? On behalf of Jesus. And that's what the Bible says, it is only when we ask in the name of Jesus that we are going to receive. So the moment I include the power in the name of Jesus, when I don't include or invite or invoke the power in the name of Jesus, meaning I am not going to receive anything. Hallelujah. Because it is the only name that we were given in heaven and below the earth. Praise the Lord. And that's why when we pray, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. You know, we are invoking the power of the name of Jesus that is here on earth, which is in heaven, and we are bringing that kingdom here on earth so that it can work for myself and for yourself. Praise the Lord. But nice as you. So God answers prayer, and He is a God who has power in His heart. Meaning, there is nothing our God cannot do. And that's why we have read from the book of Jeremiah that it is saying, "Call unto me, and I will answer you, and I'll show you great and mighty things that you know nothing about." In the time the children of God were captives in Babylon, and they cried to God, and God said, His servant, Prophet Isaiah, and he told, not Isaiah, Jeremiah, told him, "Go and tell my children to call unto me, and I am going to answer them. Let them not remain quiet." Hallelujah. So this means that as a child of God, you need to keep on calling and calling and calling and calling and calling. Amen. You know what? At times the reason why we keep quiet, it is because we called and we never received an answer. Remember, our God does not set His clock by His hour watch. He answers prayers according to His purpose and according to His will and according to His own timing. Amen. And now, when you look at the book of Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 1, you find Prophet Habakkuk really complaining and complaining and complaining. But you know what happens as he continues to have communion with God and fellowshipping with Him? We see Him as He closes this book of Habakkuk chapter 3 and verse 17, where He says, "Even though the fig tree does not bud and there's no fig in the, there's no kettle in the pen, yet my heart will rejoice in the Lord my God." Hallelujah. And this is the point that we need to come to. That even if we call and there's nothing that is coming forth, we still need to go to Him and rejoice and say, "You know what? I called. I know you heard." And in according to your own timing, you are going to do it. Because when we read Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11, the Bible says that in His own timing, He will make everything beautiful. Praise the Lord. So don't allow the enemy to continue tormenting you, continue discourage you. Because you prayed last year for something, it has not worked. It is not in the timing of God. Hallelujah. So the time that you wanted that deal, God had not planned for you to give it to you. But the moment that he has planned to give that one, when that time comes, he is going to bring it in your in his own timing. But as if you, I remember when I was in high school, there's so many things that I really prayed for. I died to have those things. I was like, God, I'll die if I don't have this one. You know what? God has to give them to me. And currently, I'm seeing God bring them. And I didn't need them. Like 10 years ago, I wanted those things. Probably the Lord looked at me and said, son, you're not mature enough to receive this one. Right? When God looks at me or looks at us as a children, ask them about the blessing that you ask. If I give you this blessing, it will throw you away from me. And since I need your fellowship, what I'm going to do? I am going to mature you first. Build your capacity to receive that answer. Because some of us here, there is something God can do, and we fail to come to church again. Me being a candidate to say bye-bye. Hallelujah. Could a blessing in the God at the letter then to find the sister to adore Kapsa? That the reason why God holds, because he really he appreciates our fellowship with him. And he likes that. That's the reason why we keep on and say, okay, with the better than me losing you, I would rather not give you what you want currently. Build your capacity first so that now I'll continue having the fellowship. Hallelujah. So I have come to encourage somebody, that friend, if you've been praying to God and he has not answered that prayer, you still answer it according to his timing. But I was fueled. Don't give up, don't be discouraged, and don't allow any negative thought to come your way. Because our God says we call unto him, he will answer. Since he said he will answer, I will say that answer when? He said, didn't he had answer when? No, he never said, I'll answer you tomorrow or the day after. No way. So the thing is, pray to God to give you patience to wait upon his own timing to answer your prayers. So knowing Jesus is the key to answered prayer. Knowing Jesus is the key to an answered prayer. And remember what the Bible says in John 10, 14. The Bible says, I am the good shepherd and I know my sheep, and I am known by my own. Jesus told the disciples that he is a good shepherd. And what the good shepherd does, he lays his life on behalf of the sheep, and they understand the voice. Hallelujah. Meaning when the enemy come and they try to call, they cannot answer. That's why, Mr. Lieutenant, if I come to your home and I go to your pen where you have your goat and your sheep and your cow, when they see me, you start making some noise. But the moment you come there, the noise you make, when they see you, the owner, the noise you make, when they see you, it's totally different. Because they have seen a stranger and they're not sure what is this stranger coming to do. But the moment they hear your voice or they hear your car when coming home, they start now mowing. Sinu kweli? Sinaza tu bleating and as in zinaza will make a lot of noise. Why? Because the owner, they know, has come. But the moment a stranger comes, are we together? The same happens to us when Jesus is a good shepherd and we know him. We know Jesus and Jesus knows us. So for us to receive any answer to our prayers, we really need to understand our relationship with the Lord Jesus. Now, being religious, knowing that there is a God, is not enough. Being religious, understanding there is God, is not enough. Coming to church every Wednesday, every Saturday, every Sunday, every now and then you come into church, it is not enough, my dear. What is enough? Enough is knowing that your relationship with the Lord Jesus is firm. Amen? There are so many differences that we can draw from somebody who comes to church and somebody who has a relationship with the Lord. It is totally, there are so many differences we can draw. The person who has a relationship with the Lord, when he calls the heaven, answers and listens. But at Chatigua, you come there and you're like, okay, let me come to the level, may not give me a call, or the leaders of the fellowship or the leaders of the church may not ask me where have I been. And you know what? There's some people who have some thinking that let me go to church so that when I die, at least it is good to go to God. Do we have such people? What? With a such belief, we want in a level at least, so that Paul, when they'll be getting married, at least I'll get support. What in the drop of present worship? Go down here, man, we get to cover, see, but friend, that should not be the main reason why you're coming to church. just come to church to have that fellowship with the Lord.
You know him personally.
Whereby when the enemy comes and he says this one, he can stand and say, you accuser, I know him. I know her. Whatever you're saying is not true. You know, when I read the word of God and I hear God speaking positively and bragging about Job, it challenges my faith. And God asked me, and where are you coming from? He says, I've come from up and down. And have you noticed my servant Job? As in, you see news, I have seen him. Have you noticed, have you identified that this person serves me? He's like, no. Not that he's so committed to you. It is because you have given him a lot. And that's the reason why this guy serves you. God continues to say, no way, this person knows me. And not because I have given him, he understands who I am. And he's like, give me a chance. I just take whatever he has. Then you see this guy forget him. God gives the enemy a chance. He goes and picks that which Job had. And he comes back. No, I'm here to realize. He goes and gives him away, and then I find everything. And we see Job never denied God. He stood and did the last minute, and because he understood his relationship with God was not with the things that he had. Amen? You know, as some of us Christians are that the moment what we have, it is thrown away from us, we and God become different people. But I am praying that God will help us to understand that our relationship with the Lord is not what we have. But no, our relationship with the Lord should be a firm decision that we have made to follow him, whether we have or we don't have. Whether we are going to receive or we are not going to receive, it is we are going to serve the Lord. Hallelujah. But there is a few. And that's why Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they said, even if he does not save us, we are not going to bow to you. We are going to worship him, even that fire. Hallelujah. And God is seeing their faith. He helped them and he removed them from the fire. And there's nothing that happened to him. Last time we were looking at the story of this wooden warrior called Hannah. Hannah, she understood as ever she knew, I there is God in the heaven who I'll continue calling until the day he answers me. And when the timing of God came, he answered, and as she received the solution to her problem. Why are you giving up on the middle? Why are you trying to give up at the middle of the journey? We have not yet reached to heaven. There's a long way to go, and we are not giving up until we get the word of what Jesus went to prepare for us, friends. Hallelujah. But nice as you. So this is our opportunity to continue calling and asking him. Now, when we read the book of Luke 8:43-44, we see a woman with an issue of blood, or the flow of blood, for the last 12 years, and she spent all what she had on physicians, and no one would heal her. And she came behind Jesus, and she said to herself, when I go to meet this person, I'm hearing his name is going to Jesus, and I touch his cloth only, or his garment, I know my flow of blood is going to cease. So it took this woman with an issue of blood for 12 years to find one who could heal her. The Bible says she spent all she had, meaning this woman was not poor. She was a rich woman because she spent all she had on physician, and even she went to an extent to consult the diviners and the witch doctors, but no one would heal her. But she came to a conclusion as she knew one thing. You know what? I am going to the person who carries my solution, the person who answered prayer. She observed all the religious activities and the cultural activities which were supposed to be observed, and she kept the social distance. She quarantined herself in a place and nobody she visited her, nobody interacted with her because of all the rules which were set. But one day she said, enough is enough. I am going to see the person who has a solution to my problem. And she came to Jesus and she said, you know what? I am going to reach out my hand and touch his cloth. Remember, her healing did not come from touching Jesus. Her healing came from connecting her faith with the healer. Praise the Lord. You know, many times people say, you know, you need to touch the cloth of Jesus and you're going to receive healing. That is it's a difference between touching and connecting yourself with the faith in the healer. Hallelujah. So she connected her faith with the healer. And she knew what? I am going to connect my faith with the one who heals. And after I connect my faith with him, I am going to receive healing. At the moment she connected her faith with the healer, she instantly received her healing. Hallelujah. Tonight, friends, we need to connect our faith with the one who called us first. The one who created me, the one who created you. Lord, don't even dwell on the things that we are hearing, the things that we are seeing, the things which are not working. You really need to communicate and connect yourself with the one who called you out of darkness into his marvelous, wonderful light. And he says, you are son. You are a daughter in the kingdom. Hallelujah. He sees that you matter to him. When I look at you, I see useless person, I see nobody, I see nothing in you. But when he sees that you, he sees, wow, this is my daughter, this is my son, this is my own, hallelujah. He resembles me, praise the Lord. And that's why I'm calling us that we connect with the one who matters and who understands us more than any other person. So we stop connecting ourselves with the people who doesn't, who cannot do anything. Praise the Lord. And now remember that our God, he has the fire in his hands and he has power to answer our prayers. And this one will take us to where we read that Elijah the prophet prayed to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and called him God. Prove today that you are the Lord that I serve. Let these people know that you alone is God who can perform a miracle. And I would like us, we read the entire, go and read the entire chapter. You find whereby Elijah tried to challenge these people, the prophet of Baal, because they had already challenged the authority in the Bible. And they had brought a lot of disbelief that there is no God. There was a lot of confusion. And he had to stand and tell them, guys, let me fix this thing. For once and for all, let's know who is the true God here. And now they called their God. He told them, let's prepare the altar. You go first and do it. Prepare the altar and sacrifice to your God. They did it. The Bible says that they did it. They called their God from morning until evening. Elijah started making fun of them. Okay, probably shout more. He might be asleep or he went for a journey. And when he shouts, he can hear you. They shouted and shouted, they started even cutting themselves. There was a pool of blood, but their God Baal never answered. And now the time came in the evening when Elijah approached the altar. And the Bible says he prepared the altar. And he even told him to dig a trench out and pour water on the altar. And he called upon God. Hallelujah. And when he called upon God, the Bible says, God came as a consuming fire. He consumed the sacrifice and even the water that was there. Praise the Lord. So when he called God in truth, the God that he served came and he did this one for his own glory. So Elijah challenged the prophet of Baal who had taken over the spiritual leadership of the people. And he started showing that the God of Israel, he has no power. This is where we need to come. You know, we Christians at times when we are confronted with the people of other faith, we don't like engaging ourselves with them. Because we're like, no, this is what I believe and all that. But it is important to stand on your ground and let people know the God that you serve. Maybe when people are like, every Wednesday in charge, every Sunday in charge, you choose your way to the women's fellowship, you're like, you know, you've no time for your family. Don't be hurt. Do it. Hallelujah. And you're not apologetic to any person. You know the reason why you go to him. You know the reason why you wake up those weird hours of the night when everybody is asleep and enjoying their sleep and you start calling him. It is you understand the sweetness in him and the connection that you have with him. But nice was with you. So no way that is God is not enough. Even the devil knows that. Hallelujah. And even he quoted the scripture. But what is more important, it is you getting out of your comfort zone and meeting with the challenger and you challenge him concerning the faith that you have in your God. He answers prayers. He answered before. He answered last year. He answered yesterday. And even this one, he is going to answer. And why are we feeling so discouraged when God is taking us not a we forget that when we were young, we prayed, God answered. Before we got married, we prayed for spouses, Jehovah brought them. When we went to that house, we prayed for children. The same God answered. Now here they are. They are looking for jobs. Why are you turning to men? Hallelujah. Why are you turning to people? To discourage you? They could give you the wrong answers. Why don't you turn to the person that you asked this blessing? And he again, you come and do it. What encourages me is one thing. For me to move forward when I'm in the midst of challenges, it is this. I look where I'm coming from. To where I am, I seek God. He who brought me that far to this point, I need to trust him again to take me to the next level. Hallelujah. And when you look God in that perspective, my dear, you know you're not going to receive any discouragement. You never allow it to come your way. Because when I tell it, I knew you're here. But you know what? The one who made a way a long time ago, the one who made a way last year, the one who made a way 10 years ago, you still make a way for me, even now, in the midst of this one. Praise the Lord. You really need to improve your faith like Daniel. He was in the pit of the lion and he knew his God. By being challenged at this top prayer, he was like, I cannot. Even he went to the upper room and opened the window that faced Jerusalem and he made prayer 3 times a day. And people trying to challenge him, they tried to get him, but they could not find any fault with him. They found fault in his God. And even after being put in the dark there, he said, no, I'm the father anything. Still, I need to go deeper. Out of him still there, and he called, he sent help from heaven. But next was fear. So, ma'am, whatever you're asking God for, whatever you're trusting God for, please just wait, he is coming. He answers prayers. He answered before. And even now, he is going to answer. So from today, choose whom do you want to believe in? Choose whom do you want to serve? Choose whom do you want to engage yourself in? Choose whom do you want to give your life to? When you give your life to your pastor, he might bring you down. When you bring your life to your man or to your woman, to your children, when you give your life or your faith to them, they might discourage you. When you give your life to the one who matters, who created you, there's no single moment will ever let you down because he has never done that before and you're not going to do this time out. But I just feel. So friends, let me like Elijah and we just go and say, our God is a miracle working God. He made a way last year. He provided a miracle last time and even now, he will. Praise the Lord. When I say to you, the reason why Peter and John, they were never shaken, when they were told that they would be put into prison or to jail because of preaching, they knew who they were preaching, who they were talking about. When I say to you, and then I didn't remember I told you, I prayed God to give me the spirit like the one which is with us. Mom, unataka peremende? Unataka maji? Unataka juice? Unataka biscuit? Hini yako na unamona unamwingi, no, tunafunga, unawe, tunafunga kiyo ya gari. Unafunga, tunafunga, unawe, hini, they are not giving up. Naomba tu ni kwa hile tu, mbaka adone nguwe vitu zingine huku unatamani kununua. I pray God give me such a persistent spirit. And I'll persist before God as I ask for something. I persist before God and I ask him to lift my faith so that I can meet with him every time that I appear before his presence. Hallelujah. Remember the woman who went appealed to the king. The Bible calls her the persistent widow. And she persisted to the king. And this king never feared God, never feared man. And now she continued and the king said, I don't fear God, I don't fear any man. But because of this woman, she's really taking out my peace. I am going to settle an issue with the adversity. And the Bible says here what a just king said. If he could say that what happens to our God, when you persist in calling the heaven has to open for you. What has he feeling? So there's so much in store for us in heaven. The thing is, we really need to know which button to press and how to connect ourselves with the right source. For us to see this light, there is a connection somewhere. There's a battle that needs to be pressed for us to see the light. Not unless we reach that point of pressing such buttons, then we are going to continue making a lot of noise and being challenged by any person who comes our way. But by the name of Jesus, we're not allowing anybody or anything to come and challenge our faith, because we know whom we have trusted in. Hallelujah. Finally, as you have children, the way your children have put their entire faith in you, and they fully depend that mom will bring me in the evening, dad will bring it in the evening, the same way we really need to do more than that and trust our God that there is no impossibility with him. He is going to do it because he is God. Hallelujah. He is God. Praise the Lord. Now, I'll let us, we arise and make some prayers. We tell God that to help us to boost our faith in him, so that now, even as we continue asking and waiting for him to answer, that our heart will not fail, to not grow weary. You really need to tell the Lord to help you, so that you wait upon his timing. He is God. He is never dictated by any situation or any circumstance. Him, he comes at all appointed time. You need to pray and tell him, God, help me to wait upon your appointed time, Lord. Help me to develop some patience with you, that the moment that you've said that you come to do it, Lord, I will have the patience to wait upon you. So go before the Lord in dinner, minute, and talk to him and tell him, Lord, give me the patience to wait upon you, so that, Lord, you, when you're coming to answer my prayers, I am not going to waver from the faith. I am not going to leave the ways, your ways, Lord, and start now putting my faith in other people and other things, but I'll put my faith, my entire faith, I'll put it in you. Jehovah, in the name of Jesus Christ tonight, I am before your presence with a thankful heart, Lord, blessing and exalting for who you are. Thank you, Jehovah, for you answered my prayers long time ago. You answered me, Lord, last year. You answered me last month. You answered me, Jehovah, in the beginning. Even now, Lord, you are the one to answer any prayer that I make. You have told me, Lord, to call upon you concerning my issues, concerning my family, concerning the ministry, concerning my children, concerning my friends, Lord. You are going to hear and answer me, Lord, and to give me something, to show me something that I've never had, something that I've never seen before, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, because I trusted you, Lord of mercy, before you gave it, oh God. Even now, I am trusting that you may act in accordance with your will and wish in heaven. In the name of Jesus, I lift your children before you. The Lord will put their faith in you, oh God, that you'll keep their faith in Jehovah attached to you, King of Glory. You'll keep their faith at that, connected to you. The Lord will give them the patience to wait upon your timing, in the name of Jesus Christ. At times, Lord, we need to appoint, we fail, we are giving up, but Lord, don't allow the enemy to torment us. Lord, don't allow the enemy to come and minister the wrong message to our ears, oh God. Give us the strength to continue holding to the faith, because you are hearing God, you are answering God. You are the one, Lord, who answers by fire. You are the one, Lord, who answers, Jehovah, in accordance with your will and wish in heaven, in the name of Jesus Christ. This night I pray for our online viewers and my Father, whatever they've been trusting you for, I pray in the name of Jesus, your way to do it, oh God, your way to answer their prayer. That those who are sick, we pray for healing in the name of Jesus. Those who are trusting you for a job, we pray, Father, may you provide one for them. That those who are trusting you for a promotion, I pray, Jehovah God, may you promote them in your appointed time, in Jesus' name. Whichever the season they are in, our God, I pray, may you come and do something new that will frustrate the expectation of the enemy concerning their life, in the name of the Lord. As our church, we continue lifting our hearts and our hands before you. As we worship you, Lord, with gratitude. As we worship you, as we worship you, Lord, with honesty in our heart, Lord, as we say, Jehovah, do something concerning our church, do something concerning our faith, do something concerning our issues, Jehovah Masha, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless you, Lord of glory, and we exalt you. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. We worship you tonight, and we magnify you, because this we pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen, amen, amen. To all my viewers, God bless you. See you on Sunday, and have a lovely night. Let me